We begin the second portion of our program with a look on recycling. According to statistics from Taiwan's Environmental Protection Agency, Taiwan's total rate of recycling in 2015 was around 55%. Recycled scrap metal has also shown a steady increase over previous years. Steel is one of the easiest and most cost-effective materials to recycle, with a recovery rate of 94% and the capability of being recycled countless times. Overall, recyclable steel is an important resource in Taiwan. Let's take a look at how the scrap metal is recycled.
Steel is the mother of modern industry, and its role in the average person's life is greater than you may be aware.
Taiwan, on average, requires about 20 million tons of steel per year. When it's factored down to the individual, that's 1 ton or 1,000 kilograms per person.
The demand for steel is always growing, just as the amount being thrown away always increases.
Items like this can, which contains iron, are some of the easiest to recycle. This type of metal is also cheap and sturdy. Since it isn't easily damaged, 100% of this item will make it through the recycling process.
Taiwan produces nearly 5,600 tons of scrap metal each year. So where does it all go?
Almost all of it can be recycled. The situation is a little different compared to last year, because the price per kilogram was only 1 or 2 NT. In the past, it was as low as half an NT dollar per kilogram. However, from this year, the value has increased to 5 or even 6 NT per kilogram.
If the amount of scrap metal is small, it will first be sent to minor suppliers for sorting. Items like household appliances, computers, cars, or scooters have to first be dismantled in different places before their components can be sorted. Once materials are sorted, batches are given to wholesalers, where pieces will be cut or crushed for processing before being sent to the steel refineries for smelting.
Here we are at the steel refinery's raw material storage area. We keep all the raw materials here, where they can be sorted for processing.
There are many kinds of scrap metal with all sorts of different compositions. To produce the best quality steel from the discarded materials, workers have to sort them accurately.
Different types of scrap metal are all sorted into these piles. For example, this area is what we call special grade iron. There are some structural components and relatively thicker pieces. This pile is called lathe iron, where most pieces were processed by a lathe for use as car parts. And then the next we have is this area for small pieces, which are the shavings from lathe works.
Given Taiwan's constrained resources, its geography and trade situation, Taiwan cannot rely on imports of steel or iron ore, which means the best recourse is to reuse and recycle the steel that Taiwan already possesses.
Then we have the electric arc furnace, which will take all those pieces of metal we just saw and smelt them down. Before the base components of the scrap are smelted out, we will do a calculation for the ratio of how much material we can recover from each batch according to the batch's weight.
The temperature in the furnace is heated to 1,600 degrees, and then the batch will be smelted. In each go, the average reclamation rate is 94% per batch. The byproduct of this process is a mixture of fly ash and slag, which after treatment can also be recycled and put to use.
The slag that is left over is actually very hard and can be used as stone aggregate or in making concrete. This byproduct of Taiwan's steel industry is actually sought after by several neighboring countries.
After the entire process of collection, sorting, smelting, and being reprocessed for new use, we can easily see how useful and important steel is to our society. Since it has such a high reclamation rate and can be reprocessed an unlimited number of times, we shouldn't destroy nature or mine mountains for more iron ore when the steel we already have is so abundant.